in the year 2021 is a particularly important year. We are approaching the midpoint of the Sustainable Development Goals, the Paris Agreement, and Sendai Framework. The expectations from COP26 to be hosted by the UK and Italy later this year are high. This partnership on resilient infrastructure must play its important role in helping meet some of those expectations. In this regard, I would like to share a few key areas that need to be accorded priority. First, CDRI must embody the central promise of the Sustainable Development Goals, that is, leave no one behind. This means that we have to put the concerns of the most vulnerable nations and communities first. In this regard, the small island developing nations that are already experiencing the impact of worsening disaster must have easy access to all the technology, knowledge, and assistance that they consider necessary. We must have the capability and support to adapt global solutions to the local context. Second, we must take stock of the performance of some of the key infrastructure sectors, particularly health infrastructure and the digital infrastructure that played a central role during the pandemic. What are the lessons from these sectors? And how can we make them more resilient for the future? At the national and sub-national level, we have to invest in capabilities for integrated planning, structural design, availability of modern materials, and a large number of skilled personnel in all infrastructure sectors. There is need for research and development in all these areas. Third, in our quest for the resiliency, no technological system should be considered too basic or too advanced. The CDRI must maximize the demonstration effect of the application of technology. In Gujarat, we built India's first hospital with bed isolation techniques. Now, bed isolators for earthquake safety are manufactured in India itself. In the current context, we have many more opportunities. We must harness the full potential of geospatial technologies, space-based capabilities, data science, artificial intelligence, material science, and combine it with local knowledge to pursue resilience. And finally, the notion of resilient infrastructure must become a mass movement, galvanizing the energies of not just the expert and formal institution, but also communities and particularly the youth.